Thanks for joining us today for day 9 of our 21 days of prayer and fasting. I got my mom here with me today. She's going to join with me so we can all pray together wherever you are at today.
Yeah. Well, today our focus is going to be about addiction. And we're going to discuss the Bible verse, John 8:36, which is, "So if the Son sets you free, you are truly free."
That's good. Yeah. That's good. So that's the thing with like addiction. When we talk about this in prayer, so often we're trying to like fix things, right? Like, could I fix this? Could I get better at this? But that's not what we're praying for.
No, that's not what we're praying for.
We're praying for like real change. Like, not like you, like, I'm going to get a little bit better or I'm going to try a little bit harder. But like, could God bring like healing into our life instead,
exactly,
right? Like real change. This is actually the reflecting point we'd love for you to think about for a second, okay? What is controlling you in ways that you don't want? Think about it that way. Because sometimes maybe we're like, oh, I don't have any addictions.
Yeah.
But that's where we can fool ourselves, right? Be like, oh, I'm not addicted. But think about it that way. What's controlling you in ways that you don't want? I mean, that could be stuff like food. A lot of us have issues with food where it's like, anytime I'm sad, I want to eat. Or anytime this, like those problems. But also, I mean, it could really be the fact that, especially with what this last year was, with what all the situation is now, maybe we're using substances we shouldn't be and leaning into them.
Well, I was saying just recently to somebody that I would say that this year has been one of the most difficult years. I think if someone really does have a struggle with addiction, that this would be one of the most difficult years, because you would truly want to almost escape some of the things that have gone on in this world. You'd almost want to try to almost like medicate or block out what's going on in the world, and that people would want to kind of almost have that feeling to go back to something. That's why we need Jesus, that he can actually break that completely in our lives, you know.
Here's an addiction you don't think about. Social media.
Yeah.
Checking Facebook or Instagram every few minutes, or checking the news every few minutes to be like, what's happening? Is something happening? Is something happening?
Right.
And that can be an addiction that we lean to. And obviously, then there's just, I mean, things that will stick in our spirit for years and years, which is like, you know, I've talked about before, the addiction I had for years was pornography. Once you start looking at something like that it's so difficult to get away from. But this is the point. What we're saying is, we have seen God break addictions in people's lives, that he can actually give them freedom from it. So my thought is this, I mean, kind of two ways, right? We should be praying. If you have something that is in your life, man, we need to be praying. But also too, I'm guessing there's people, even if right now, maybe everything's great, I guarantee you know somebody who's struggling.
Oh yeah.
All of us know someone who's struggling.
Definitely.
So this is an important day to pray and fast, especially, you know, if you've been struggling with this, I'd encourage you, wherever you're at, even if it's halfway through the day, maybe today you just want to start fasting this moment and be like, hey, I'm going to fast and just use that to kind of pressurize this, because I really want to move in this area.
Yeah, if there's something that maybe you're kind of feeling, you know, I feel I don't really have an addiction to, but maybe that you kind of do notice that you go to something as kind of like something to release or escape something. So if you go to that and you realize that, maybe that's what you do need to fast.
Yeah.
And really change about.
I think that's good. Yeah. All right, let's pray together. You go ahead.
All right. Well, Lord, we are so thankful that you're so good and that you do set us free. I just pray, Father, that right now, Lord God, you just bring to mind those things that we would use that would cause us to go to that area in our lives, Lord, that substance or that distraction or whatever it is could be pulling us apart and pulling us farther away from you, Lord. We just pray that you would bring it to light. And Lord, that you would help us, Lord God, to just lay it at your feet, Lord God, lay it at your altar, that we could actually be just delivered from this addiction in our lives. Lord, we just pray for those that right now are struggling, Lord, those that have really been caught up in this year, Lord God, with things that are really caused them a lot of pain and struggle, Lord God, with this addiction. We just pray for deliverance, Lord God. We just pray for your healing. And we just pray, Father, that you, Lord God, would just heal their bodies, Lord God. We just pray that you'd heal their minds and their hearts, Lord. If there's any guilt that has lingered out of these addictions, Lord God, I just pray that you would break it, Lord. We know that you're a God of forgiveness, and Lord, you convict us, but you never condemn us. And we're so thankful for that.
Thank you.
Lord, we just praise you, and we thank you for everything you're going to do and help you people to break free of their addictions in their lives, Lord. We thank you for everything in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Hey, one last thing before you go. If you have an addiction that you're praying and believing God to break, I have one last challenge for you. Send somebody a text who loves you and you love, and say, hey, I'm praying that God would heal me, would break this in my life, but would you walk through with me? Because I think one of the last parts is definitely that we also confess to someone we love and say, here's something I'm struggling with. Would you pray with me? There's power in prayer, and also just the fact of kind of not like coming clean, but just saying like, yeah. I need someone to walk through this with me. Yeah. You're not meant to do it on your own.
Yeah. Bring it to the light.
Absolutely.
That's good.
All right. Keep praying.
Yeah.